Lead exposure can affect nearly every system in the body, and although people of all ages can be at risk, young children and pregnant women are most vulnerable. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, no safe blood lead level in children has been identified, and at least 4 million households in the United States have children living in them that are being exposed to high levels of lead.
Lead is a neurotoxin. Of course, it affects all of us, adults and children, but being that children are developing, they uptake nutrients at a much faster rate.
Lead poisoning is still common, although I think many pediatricians and families do not believe it to be, but we still have quite a bit of lead poisoning, especially in Missouri, because of the large number of homes that we have that were built before 1978.
The United States Environmental Protection Agency states that if a home was built before 1978, there is a good chance it has lead-based paint. Deteriorating lead-based paint that is peeling, chipping, or cracking is a hazard and needs immediate attention.
We call it alligatoring, where if you look at it, it has a very distinct alligator-like pattern to it as it deteriorates. Paint chips laying on the floors, windowsills, and in the window troughs themselves are important areas to look at, you know, as well as your walls. So if you see that you have a lot of chipping paint, that's something to be concerned about. And what you can do immediately is what we call a two-bucket cleaning method, where you will take a warm bucket of soapy water and wash down the areas that you saw the paint chips and the dust and get that cleaned up, and then rinse it again with a warm bucket of just rinse water.
Lead dust can also be tracked into the home from soil outside that is contaminated. Deteriorated paint and other lead sources, such as industrial pollution, mining debris, and past use of leaded gasoline, are common causes.
Gasoline getting into the air and then dropping into the soil, especially if you live near an old highway or you live by highways now, there could be lead in the soil. Kids like to go out and make their little mud slurries and play in it and that kind of thing. To prevent those kids from getting into that soil, it's really important just to plant grass and put something on there so that they don't have easy access to that soil that's there.
If you have any concerns about contaminated soil, prevent children from playing in bare soil if possible. Remember, hand washing is important for everyone in the household, and pets can also bring lead into a home if they have been outside in lead-contaminated soil. Lead in tap water may also be a concern. Materials like pipes and fixtures that contain lead can corrode over time. If you have an old plumbing system built before 1970, which used copper pipes and lead solder, you may want to have your water tested. You can call your local health department or water department to find a laboratory that will test your water for lead content. You can also take precautions to limit your exposure. If the water from the cold faucet has not been run for several hours, let the cold water run for 30 seconds before drinking. And because hot water absorbs more lead than cold water, don't use hot tap water for meals or preparing baby formula. Other sources of lead exposure in the home include occupational take-home by people who work with lead in their jobs or hobbies, bullets and other forms of ammunition, fishing sinkers, paint sets, art supplies, jewelry and pottery, traditional ethnic medicines, spices and candy, and toys made and painted outside of the United States.
We still have to this day imports that come from China and other places that, you know, have lead paint on them. And as part of a regular risk assessment, a lot of times we'll be looking for toys, especially painted toys, like wood blocks or older toys that, you know, have been hand painted. We look for those as sources.
Lead poisoning is entirely preventable. This is why it is so important that lead hazards in a home are identified, controlled, or removed safely.
The best thing is actually prevent lead poisoning from happening in the first place. So I try to encourage families and pediatricians and family practitioners to know about the home that they are actually moving into. So before a baby goes home from the nursery, let's ask about the home and make sure that, you know, we prevent it from happening. Because once the exposure has happened, then we're kind of playing catch up.
Anyone with concerns about lead poisoning should contact their physician as soon as possible and should also reach out to their local or state health department for guidance and information. To help educate families and children about the dangers of lead poisoning, the Missouri Department of Health and Senior Services has a mascot named Leadosaurus, or Leddy for short, who visits fairs, festivals, and public events. For more information on lead poisoning prevention, you can follow the links below in the description of this video or visit health.mo.gov.